I've been having dreams, jumping on a trampoline, flipping in the air. I never land, just float there.
Chlorpromazine. Chlorpromazine.
Can we just call it Thorazine?
I would prefer Thorazine.
That's just much easier to say. Welcome back to LPT Live, everyone. I am Mel. I'm a California LPT regulating today.
I'm AJ, the Quizmaster. Oh, wait, but I'm also an LPT.
Today's episode is about chlorpromazine.
Chlorpromazine.
Did I say it right?
Yes. Better known to all of you other LPTs out there as Thorazine.
Dun, 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 dun.
Promazine.
Chlorpromazine.
But it's called Thorazine. I wonder if it has any...
Chlorthorazine.
No, but I wonder if it has any... I wonder if it has anything to do with Thor, like Thor, the god of thunder. Thorazine. Because it drops the hammer.
It drops the hammer.
It drops the hammer.
That's how you can remember it, yeah.
So today... we are going to talk about the first antipsychotic.
Thorazine was accidentally invented in 1952.
By Henri Laborde, a surgeon in Paris. Before Thorazine was invented, the transorbital lobotomy was the standard practice.
Midline is similarly indicated. Operations can be performed under local anesthesia if the patient is sufficiently cooperative. An incision through the scalp along the indicated line exposes the coronal suture.
He was looking for a way to reduce the shock in patients who went under anesthesia.
He noticed when he gave a strong dosage that his patient's mental status had changed. They didn't care that they were going into surgery and they felt less anxious. They started using the medication in psychiatric settings and noticed that it was very effective for patients who had been violent in the past or needed to be restrained.
It took the country by storm.
And fell in love. I asked my sweetheart, what lies ahead? Will we have rainbows day after day? Here's what my sweetheart said. Case set off.
In 1954, chlorpromazine was approved by the Federal Food and Drug Administration for use.
However, they soon found out that some of the side effects had a few drawbacks. Common side effects for Thorazine, y'all should know, is number one, tardive dyskinesia. Patients on Thorazine can often maybe feel restless, unable to sit still.
Patients on Thorazine can suffer from dizziness and low blood pressure.
Okay. Sleep. You got it.
Also, patients on Thorazine may have Parkinson's-like symptoms.
That's because Thorazine plays a key role on dopamine and other neurotransmitters. Thorazine can be given by PO or IM.
I prefer to give it IM.
Thorazine can also be given IV. If you have to give Thorazine IM, know that it can come in an ampoule or a regular vial. Thorazine is pretty easy to draw up. It is not a thick medication. After giving this medication to a patient, make sure that you are checking for any EPS symptoms. You may need to contact the doctor if you're noticing any adverse reaction to the medication.
An anticholinergic, anti-Parkinsonian ingredient may be needed to counteract EPS.
I know none of you want your clients or patients to be doing the Thorazine shuffle, so make sure you're doing your nursing checks. Thank you for watching LPT Live.
Bye, guys.